Hi honeys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Bee. If you're new here, I do have information down below in the description box. Okay, so I have another general reading for you guys. As you can see, I have your cards ready to go and we are going to get right into this reading. So I feel like this is, you kind of stumbled on this reading because you want to know about someone in particular, someone that you're dealing with. Okay, this could be your ex. Okay, this could be just somebody you're romantically interested in and you want to see what's up with them, you want to see what's going on in their life. You know, take whatever resonates. There's a bunch of scenarios coming through here, but I am seeing that there is somebody who felt like all their identity was a part of this relationship that they were in. They felt like they had met the person. They felt like this was the person that they were going to spend the rest of their life with. And I'm seeing that that mentality changed very, very quickly after they saw this person's true colors and realized that they're not being treated in the way that they deserve. As I say that, my throat chakra goes in and out. That just goes to show me that this person has yet to communicate any of this to you or anyone else in their life. I'm definitely sensing that they have not communicated what's going on in their life with other people. And so this person seems a little bit mysterious to you. And that's where you're coming in this reading, because you want to see what's up. You want to see what's going on with them, right? You want to see what's happening behind the scenes. Well, they're hurting. They're in a lot of pain. And I'm seeing that they may be having trouble sleeping. They may have really bad insomnia. Okay, they're having a lot of regret and a lot of remorse for putting so much of themselves into this relationship, where they came out of this relationship not knowing who they are anymore. They lost a sense of their identity because they really put a lot of their happiness, love, and even a piece of their soul into the person that they were dealing with's hand. And they kind of felt like they lost a part of themselves when they lost the person that they were dealing with. This person is in deep pain. I cannot stress that enough. So much pain is coming through in these cards and I can feel it, and it's getting a little overwhelming. So I'm getting that they do a great job at hiding things on the outside. They're this person that, you know, shows people that they're a badass and that nothing hurts them, that nothing phases them, that, oh, you know what, I broke up with them, or we broke up, but I'm fine, I'm good. No, they're not. They're not good. And this could even be you I'm talking to, this person I'm reading for. Again, take whatever resonates, okay? So this person is showing up as the Empress, but it's in reverse. However, I'm still gonna call this person the Empress. I just saw 444. So I'm hearing that the angels stepped into this connection. They looked at this Empress and they said, excuse me, this relationship that you're in is not serving you. It's not making you happy. It's not making you satisfied. And it's making you feel a lack of abundance. It's making you forget who you are. So the angels came, they snatched this Empress out of this toxic energy, okay, out of this codependency that the Empress was in. And it freaking hurt. Now, the angels are not to blame. So I do not want to see in my comments, oh, it's my angels. No, sir. The angels came, or no, sir, no, ma'am, no, whatever, no, honey. The angels came in almost like a lifeguard, because this Empress was drowning. They were suffocating. They were being diminished. Their self-value was diminishing every second of the day that they were spending with this karmic. I just saw 555. That's sad. That's sad, because when I hold this card, I can feel like the innocent intentions that this Empress had in the relationship. And as I say that, my throat is like breaking in and out. I feel like it makes this Empress cry. It makes them feel sad, because they're kind of looking at this like, why didn't this work? Why? You know, I put everything into this. I'm not me about to cry. You know, your energy is really strong, or this person's energy is really strong. And they have a lot of emotions that they need to figure out. They have a lot of things that they need to address. And if this is you, if I am talking to you, if you are the Empress, You need to release these emotions because it will continue to eat you up inside. You will continue to have a hard time sleeping. You will continue to go about your day feeling lonely because you're not letting anybody in. That was a strong message for you if you are the Empress. Now going back to the overall message. So, like I was saying, the toughest thing that I'm seeing about this person being represented by the Empress is that they may have had kids in the situation. They could have been married, okay? They could have had a contract with their lover here or their ex-lover, and it really binded them together in an unhealthy way. I feel like this Empress is not lying to themselves though. I see that this Empress is deciding to see this person for who they are. That maybe in the past, when this Empress met this lover, they ignored all of the red flags because they got so carried away with love and wanting to be loved that they forgot that they are love. And so this kind of made them overlook little things here and there, little red flags, you know, here and there. Maybe this person started out by getting a little angry with things that didn't make sense, or testing this Empress's boundaries to see how much this Empress would let them get away with. Then it started to get really heavy, and this Empress started to notice that their lover was lying and betraying them and talking bad about them. Then it escalated even more to the biggest betrayal that could ever be known. Cheating, lying, I keep hearing the word infidelity, to be honest. So this could have been infidelity, or this Empress just realized that this person that they were involved with had very selfish intentions, and they had a hard time seeing this at first because they were just so carried away. But you know what, that happens even to the best of us. So I'm hearing that this Empress at this time is learning to love themselves again. That even though they may have lost a part of themselves in this relationship, that they are going to eventually be happy. They just need to start out with loving themselves from square one. Okay, so there is a lot of strong energy. I did go ahead and shuffle more cards because the energy was getting a little stagnant, so I had to pull some more. So, okay, here's the thing. Here's like the promising news. If you are watching in regards to this Empress, you have a love offer to give. And I feel like that's what you kind of brought to this reading, because you kind of needed like that little sign from spirit saying, now's your chance. Go in, shoot your shot, because this person is single. I'm saying that they're single, they're not entertaining anybody, if you're curious. Now, my Empress, the Empress that I was talking to before. So, whether this is known to you or not, I understand that this was painful. I understand like soul ties are the hardest thing to break ever, because for some reason they feel so comfortable. But you know that comfort hurts you, and you've seen that firsthand, and you've seen how a soul tie can diminish your value in your own eyes, because you then start to treat yourself in the way that this other person treated you, which is terribly. They did not treat you like the Empress deserves to be treated. They treated you like you were replaceable. They treated you like you were an option, and they treated you like if you were to walk away, they wouldn't care, because they have so much ego and so much pride, and that is not your problem. I'm seeing that even though like this ended very abruptly and painfully and agonizingly, there is somebody here who wants to give you a lot of love, a lot of it. Look at that. King of Cups. I'm hearing nothing but good things about this person that is going to be coming into your life. Nothing but good things. Do you know how, my dear Empress, when you were in this relationship and you would be sitting there, because I'm seeing you, I'm literally seeing you, crying your eyes out and just praying and asking, oh my gosh, like I love them so much. Why can't they just change? Why can't they just be better? Why can't we just work? You know why? It's because it wasn't meant to work. And that's probably the freaking hardest thing to hear. But it may also bring you a little bit of reassurance that no matter how hard you tried, you were not the problem. It was not you. This was just a connection to help guide you to the person of your dreams. The person that's going to love you for everything that you are. And guess what? This person, you're not going to have to beg for them to change because they are already healed. King of Cups, okay? You know who the King of Cups is, all right? Somebody who is willingly giving affection. Somebody who is willingly stepping up and respecting your boundaries. Somebody who is not going to leave you crying at 3 a.m. outside of your house, wondering why the hell things are going wrong, because they're going to be there to comfort you. And when things are going wrong in the relationship, they're going to hold your hand, and they're going to look at you and they're going to say, hey, we can figure this out together as a team. Because I feel like that's what your heart craves. That's what your heart wanted. And you tried your best to help this ex-lover of yours change, and you've poured so much of your damn self into this person that you feel like you are the Queen of Cups in reverse, that you have nothing more to give. That's okay. You're starting out page one. I'm hearing a beautiful song. This is my shit. That song that I'm hearing is my favorite. I'm gonna put it on the side of the screen, okay? The song is all about, you know, you're staring at the blank page in front of you, and even though you're starting from square one, open your eyes and realize that this is a blank page and you get to start all over again. And you can either see it as a toxic, sad thing, or you can see it as you finally have your life back and you're gonna finally get that fire back within you to love yourself and to demand respect, because you are the Empress. Have you forgotten? Yes, you have. You forgot who you are. You're this badass empress, regardless of your gender. You have so much damn love to give. And let me tell you something, okay? Let me tell you a secret. Just between me and you, Empress. Not you, King of Cups. I'll get to you in a minute, okay? But just between me and you, Empress, all right? Just because they did not love you does not mean that you are not worthy of love. Does not mean that you are incapable of being loved. It means that they don't deserve you, period. And I want you to remind yourself that every single time you find yourself getting sad and you find yourself mourning the loss of this relationship, I want you to look in the mirror and I want you to ask yourself, why am I going to cry over somebody who did not mind losing me? Because anybody that would not want to lose you would do everything in their damn power to make sure that doesn't happen, in a healthy way, of course. I just saw 1515. So, powerful message for you, Empress. Don't forget who you are. You're a badass, okay? Now, King of Cups, here we go. Let me get to the good part, okay? Let me give you some advice, all right? Here's the thing. Come closer, come. Listen, this Queen of Cups has been through some shit. And she or he or whatever gender may tell you this a little bit farther off into the future. Because remember, this Queen of Cups here, they're not even telling their closest family members. They're not even being honest with themselves about how much they're hurting on the inside. So if you're willing to give this person your love, your cup of love, okay, your King of Cups love, then you need to be patient. And you need to understand that this person here needs to do some healing before this connection can come together. Now, if you're willing to do that, I'm seeing that this is going to be a bomb-ass relationship. This is gonna be so damn beautiful. I can freaking see it, and it just moves me to tears, okay? You are going to be holding each other's hands, looking up at the sky and being like, oh my gosh, this is why all of those past relationships didn't work out, so that it can lead me straight to you. I'm hearing a song. Ugh. This song, this ring is so freaking beautiful. I'm gonna leave the song on the screen, okay? I'm gonna leave it on the screen. I have to like lean in because the sun is like blinding me. But maybe that's like, you know, I'm gonna take that as like a sign, okay? The sun will come out tomorrow. So I almost yanked you. Oh God, Jesus. So I'm gonna take the fact that the sun is blinding me, okay? I feel like you could be dealing with a fire sign. So Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Or you could be a fire sign, take whatever resonates, and this may be somewhere in your birth chart, okay? Now, the thing is, you guys are gonna have this gorgeous relationship that you need to come together in a healed manner. So it's very important to understand that even though it's a very healthy relationship, it's gonna be very beautiful, and you're also going to encourage each other to heal, that you must come as your best self. You must come as as healed as much as possible, if that makes sense, okay? Because King of Cups, I can see that you've been through some stuff too. I can see, I can feel it. And that's why you have so much sympathy and empathy for this Queen of Cups, that you're that I really truly feel like you don't mind being patient. And Queen of Cups, you're going to see this King of Cups as somebody who's going to uplift you, and they're going to, it's almost like you're taking a big breath of fresh air, like, oh my gosh, like, you can breathe, okay? You don't have somebody toxic on your back all the time. So just remember, the both of you need to be patient when this is coming together. You need to give it time. I'm hearing a song. I'm gonna put it on the side of the screen. Man, I'm hearing a lot of songs. Yeah, I don't doubt it. King of Cups, Queen of Cups, you two may find that music is very healing. So it is important at this time, especially you, my beautiful divine feminine here, you need to be listening to some very healing music, something that speaks to your soul, something that allows you to cry, something that really opens your heart again. And you know what? You may also, both of you may also benefit from listening to like heart chakra. What? You both might benefit from listening to heart chakra music of unblockages, okay? Unblocking your heart chakra. There's a bunch of frequencies that you can find on YouTube. They're free and they work amazing. So make sure that you use them at this time, both of you, right? Because when you heal, you encourage this other person to heal. King of Cups, if you want to shoot your shot, let me give you some advice before we end this reading. I just saw 2002. Send this person some songs. You can start out just like that. Be like, hey, I was thinking about you today. I heard this song and I want you to listen to it. Here's a song. Boom. Okay. That's like a good conversation starter, right? So give me credit, okay? If it works out, let me know down in the comments. Okay. You know what? Also, let me help you out even more, King of Cups. This Queen of Cups may also like to read, right? They may like to read a lot. They also like to study. Very intelligent, okay? All right, so let's go ahead, let's get some initials just to help this reading resonate even more. Whew, okay, so as long as I sit back like this, the sun won't like smack me in the face. Okay, so here is what we have. We have some descriptions and we have some initials. I'm gonna go through both of them, so yeah, let's do it. These descriptions can either resonate with you or it can resonate with the person you're dealing with. Or however you flip this, you know, just use it as you will. Okay, somebody has a poker face. Somebody is a chaser here. We also have Libra. Spirit wants you to know that you are protected. This person could work in customer service and struggling with self-love. Okay, I feel like that's definitely for our divine feminine here. Sagittarius, the life path number 5. We also have spiteful, unique birthmark. The number 22. Or this could just be the year 22. Forbidden fruit, the number 7. Straight hair, social butterfly. A dreamer, very loving, the number 1111, understanding. We also have the message, I am not good for you. Cute laugh. You are having a tower moment. Yeah, we did get the tower card. We also have the numbers 999. You care about each other but won't say it. Somebody here is wild. They may be younger. They may look younger. Oh my gosh, there goes my throat chakra. Curly hair. The number 2222. Religious. Awakened. Temptation. And lastly, this person could be blonde. And now the initials. So we have NCHNTRJU. OMMAHMOBFQDXLNF. Wow, what a reading. Okay, I really hope that these messages help you. Queen of Cups, do your thing. You're beautiful, okay? You're the Empress too, don't forget. And King of Cups, shoot that shot, okay? You'll make it, don't worry. All right, honeys, I really hope you enjoyed that. If you did, don't forget to leave me a like, comment down below. Make sure that you subscribe if you're new here. And like I always say, take care, be safe. And yeah, I guess I hope your life continues to stay as sweet as you are. Bye.